Good morning. So, Snippet Pixie next, and we're kind of at a point where we can start filling out the GUI, the main page of the list of snippets with new controls, new features. So, let's get a reminder where we're at. So, what should we do? I better make sure that I've got everything up and running. So, yeah, so that's there. Let's get this going. So, here's the dev version. Bring it up. So if we've got snippets, we're getting this list here, and I can filter it, and I can clear the search, and I can go into the list anytime, and then I can go down, pick an item, and in this case, if I hit return, it's going to go paste into the terminal behind me. I'm holding shift at the same time, so it pastes into the terminal. And there it goes. I just put the always developing and then today's date. So that's the basics up and running there. But what we also need is the ability to add from this list and edit from this list. So to add snippets and so on. So I think the first thing I'll do is get an add button here somewhere. I think I'm going to put it to the left of the search. And then we'll look at how we're going to do the edit as well. So let's just stick this over here, make it a bit smaller. Stick it in the corner. And do some things. Right, don't think we need the dbus stuff at the moment. We need the GUI. So let's list snippet screen we want. So at the moment, the screen has the input, and then if we've got any results, it shows the snippets, the list of snippets. Otherwise, it just shows there's no snippets found. So if I do nope. No snippets found. Please try entering a different search term. That's what it shows instead. I think that'll do for the moment. We could do something like add. I can add, put an add button there, and it maybe starts off with one which includes that abbreviation as such, maybe, but I think that's maybe for the future. So in the what we want now is to see if we can squeeze an add button here. Now, in our components, we do have an icon button. And in the div, we might be able to get away with that. We're already using that on the welcome screen here. And we probably want the same button, I think. Let's try that then. Now the issue is going to be we're using flex and it's not going to be happy. Just sitting there. Oops, sorry, up here. Then you put it in the wrong place anyway. So we may need to put a little wrapper around these two. Let's stick it in anyway. Oh, that's not what I wanted. That's what I wanted. So we'll import that. We will import that. And we'll create that in a minute. Let's move these around a bit. Now, if I save that, I think it's going to be a bit of a mess. What? Oh. Oh. Act, can I do this? Why is that not? It's obviously broken. Hold on a sec. Don't think I can do what I just tried to do, but I want to make sure it's properly broken. Yeah. Okay. Don't think it likes. I think because it's got a slot, it needs that. Oh, it could be the add snippet handler, actually. That could be breaking it. Let's just test that before we go further. I'm going to change that as well. Okay. Let's see if that compiles it. Right, okay. It was just broken because we didn't have a valid reference there. That's fine. Now, we need to do some things here. So, first off, we want to change the scale. Let's see what 2 does. That's probably too big. Can I do... leave it at that for the moment. Now, the problem we have here, the is that we need it to be in a row with the input. And at the moment, we've got the screen. Setting the flex direction to column by default. So what should we do? We could make it a component of its own. Which would be interesting. We're probably not going to use it anywhere else. So let's just try this. Have I done this before? Do I have a style that I can use already? Oh no, it's centered. What did I do on them? List item. It's just a list item, so. Just did that. Okay, in that case, what we'll do here I think we will let's just call it toolbar, because I think that's what it's going to come, might one day become an actual component. Should be able to do this. Display flex. Flex direction. Actually, I probably don't even need that. Hold on. Yeah. Then we need to do. We do need to nick kind of a bunch of stuff from here. Gap align item center. We'll see. Okay. And then surprised I haven't got a flex. Haven't got anything to adjust the sizes on that. I am surprised. Didn't need that for some reason. Okay. Yeah, we're going to struggle here. What's the style like on that? Nothing, okay. Right, so that's done another flex with everything centered, and then the input right. Yeah, so I'm going to have to do the same thing. This could be interesting. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do that. So I've got to somehow push the input out. Can't do this, I think. No. Oh, can I? Make any difference. Can't read the thing. Flex grow, flex shrink, or flex basis. Right, auto. The item is sized according to its width and height properties, but grows to absorb any extra space. Container and shrinks to its minimum size to fit the container. It's equivalent to 110. So, what I could actually do maybe is just width. Apparently not. I have to start looking at the browser. Yeah. Okay. Not quite sure what the structure is there. It's maybe doing something a little bit different to what I expect. Let's do a little refresh on there so I can check the data. Okay. Ah, of course. That's not got the width we want anyway. We could actually push that out. That's probably the problem there. So, this probably needs pushing out. No, okay, what about width? Yeah, neither of those are working. All right, so that's correct. Ish. That's okay. That's not picking up the changes at all. Okay. So I need to find another way of targeting that. That has got its width 100%. It's actually too much. kind of want it to be the same as the unordered list. Little bird at the window. Okay. Right, I'm going to have to find a way of breaking this out. Because it's not doing what I want to do. I can't target it that way. I just give it a class. This is not the way I want to do it, but let's try this. No, it's still not working. Oh, it's got it. Okay. Oh no, it's the input. Okay, I'm going to have to hoist it up into the DOM as such. I'll find a way of getting it to expand. Doing that thing there, and then the toolbar. Okay, so that's correct now. Toolbar's got the right width. If I do flex. But okay, and that is keeping its minimum width there. Okay, let's try a couple of things then. So we want that there. Don't think I can use that. It's so that's going to have the same width. I might take out the padding, but we'll see. In fact, I probably will. Hold on, before I do that, save that. Okay, yeah, that's better. I want... is it justify or align content center? Nope. Ah, okay. That's not what I wanted. Just annoying that that button is off. I'll have to muck about that in a minute. I'll have to go look up again. Blinking flex, you never know which ones to use. Okay. Okay, so somehow I've got to get this thing to take up more room. Do I dare? Well, that's right, but is it going to ruin it for Ed? Yeah, it's not happy now. Was it just that though? No, okay. So I broke it. Somewhere else. Okay, we'll look at that in a minute then. So that's kind of okay, but I still need to get that properly aligned with that. I don't know why it's not doing what it's supposed to do. Let's refresh. Because I've got some edits in there. Yeah, it's definitely off. Okay. I think. Oh, I've got that there. I don't know why this is. Let's make no difference. It knows its row. It's a padding thing. That's got no padding. My input. It's got no padding or margin. It's div. So I should be able to align them. Very confused again by the flex. It's so annoying. I've obviously got too many things going on here and too many levels, and I'm not quite sure what's what. It could just be. Could be. Right, hold on. So we know that's working now, because I'm gonna get shot at that. Okay, now we know the two bar toolbars working there. sets the aligned self value on all direct children as a group. Controls alignment of items on the cross axis. You can grid layout controls, blah blah. Interactive example below. Demonstrates. Okay. Learn again, so right, if I'm blah blah, display flex, justify content, okay, yeah, that's space between, yeah, and the line items, they're stretched, so they go to the top and bottom. But if I were to, oops, I'll just add it here. Yeah. Which is what I want. And why is it not working? That's exactly what I wanted, and it's not doing. Well, that did change there. Oh, okay. So it is doing it, but I've got some mysterious. Oh, it'll be the slot. Yeah, okay. So what's happening, I think, is inside the icon, it's got some extra space somehow. Looks okay there. Okay, so the icon itself has a different setup. That is picking up from there. Flex direction column, align items center. That's bringing it into the middle there. And what I want then is justify content as well, maybe. I think. That didn't work yet. Is it item then? No. Justify content does what? Same thing. Quite what I wanted, I think. I got to put it sets the distribution of space between and around content items along a flex box's cross axis. How does that differ? Justify. Main axis. Right. Okay. So align content does what I want for in column. It's basically aligning it up or down. And justify it's like text, justify text if you're on row, sorry. So I do want align content. And then align items. It's a weird one, that one. Okay, but I want align content for sure. But whether it works or not is another matter. I do need that's doing the align items, which is correct in this mode. But in here, I want align content. It says, why does that not work? Could do them all, and it's still not going to work. There's something in the way. It's just not doing what it's supposed to do. What is it? What's getting in the way? Oops. Okay. Let's cheat. No, it's definitely off. I don't know what that is. Don't know why you won't do the do. See, if I did this, I'd just put that in there. It makes it really obvious. Actually, let's take out the scale again. It's interesting this is not refreshing at the moment. That kind of does look centered now. That's 57, and that's 57. There's maybe a slight offset there. Sorry, 1 second. Sorry, so I'm collecting something there. I think I'm gonna have to give this a think. It's just annoying. It's not like hugely off, but I really don't want I don't want that to be offset. It's just annoying. And I'm going to have to find out what's going on here as well. Okay. Well, I've run out of time, as always. So I'll have to come back to this. It's always blinking flex now. Always balancing different things. Okay. All right. Gotta go. Until next time. Thanks for watching. And take care. Bye.